What's going on, you guys? I'm Nina from the Todd and Nina Morning Show. Very lucky, unfortunately, sitting right next to the so talented darling Andy Grammer. Welcome, darling. Welcome to our
Good Night Lounge. This is
really nice. Isn't it? You're like the second artist to make his way up on the stage.
This is really nice. That's all said. It's beautiful in here.
Not to put any pressure on you or anything, because
who was your first?
Who do I have to beat?
Was the 1975s. They were here about a week ago.
They're pretty awesome. That's good.
Have you seen them?
I haven't seen them live, but I was listening to them this morning. Really good.
Actually was.
I went on a run this morning, listened to them. They're great.
Yeah? Well, that's fun, because we love having Andy Grammer around, because he comes to SAC a lot. Last time I saw you, we were playing on the same volleyball team at Now Splash, and you're getting super competitive.
I was. You know what's funny? There were some other people that were playing, too. It was like it was supposed to be artists playing, and I was the only one that showed up, like, legit, with shorts, and, like, I didn't look good. People showed up in, like, leather jackets and stuff, and I had my... I came ready to go. I think I had a headband and like basketball shorts and stuff. I was like, oh, this is like, I'm sorry.
No, because you were giving me a pep talk and the rest of our team because he seriously wanted to win.
I did. I think we did win, didn't we?
I think we did.
Okay, good.
We usually do. But you did admit that you have a competitive personality and that's kind of something that you do with yourself and everything.
Yeah, totally. I don't want to be mean about it, but I'm pretty like competitive.
There's nothing wrong with being competitive. I'm just wondering if that's something that you do with yourself, especially when you're starting to put out new music. Why do you always have the summer anthem? This song is dropping right now. Perfect timing. You always have the song that everybody's listening to.
Oh, man. You know, hopefully. I took a long time on the second album, and I was just so, I'm so happy that we got that this one was on the album because it feels like really, I like it a lot. I think it's really good. I know, it's like the only reason I can say that is because I wrote so many that aren't. So I wrote like 100 songs for this album. And then to get one that makes everybody feel this way, it makes all the others worth it, all the time you put in.
Okay, well, what makes this one different? What's it about?
I honestly have no idea. That's what's crazy.
Shut up. You're such a liar.
No, I don't know. Like, what's interesting is you write songs and you just kind of go after what you're feeling that day, what you think you want to get across, and then sometimes all the things, everything comes together and it makes someone feel. While another time you put chords and a melody and something that you think is beautiful and you play it for someone, they're like, I got nothing on that one. But then sometimes you put a song together and it makes, you can see when they listen to it, like it makes them feel something, and that's really cool.
So do you have to wait until you see somebody have that physical reaction, or do you know when you're done and you hear it for the first time, I did it?
Okay, so this is the thing, is that like, I think I know, but all it takes is two or three times to be like, that's a smash hit, and no one likes it. So then you're like confused about how, exactly what you know. So this one, I did feel that, but you start to get like a little bit, I don't want to speak. I don't talk that much about it anymore. Because while you're writing, writing is such like a weird thing. You could write a song and literally be crying because you're like, this is so beautiful. like, this is exactly what I've been trying. And then you play it for someone like, not good. Because after so many times of writing songs and sharing with people and having them say that it's not good, or just, now you don't have to say, you can just tell, you play it for someone and be like, no, that's really good. So you have to keep getting excited. It's interesting.
Well, and it's really positive. It's another one of those upbeat songs that you're going to drive around with your windows down. And you are such a positive guy. Like, is that how you are all the time? Or is that more just the Andy that we get to see?
I'm a pretty positive guy, I'd say. I try to keep it positive. You know? Positive is such a cheesy word. I like to think of, like, it's like, there's a difference between someone who's positive and just kind of, like, annoyingly positive, or someone who's been through and is still positive.
Right.
That's what I like to try to do.
And your video, your lyric video, he was actually showing me right before you guys all walked in here. I was checking it out because his dog, Lucy, is in the video, and you are cheesing.
Yes.
You are holding her on your lap in the lyric video, and you are cheesing. Does she just make you so happy?
Lucy's the best. So she's a French Bulldog. Check out the lyric video, Not Even For Me. My dog's a star. It's like right in the beginning, and she's gorgeous.
And you called in some favors. Other friends join you in the lyric video as well?
Yeah. A bunch of my friends from LA, my actual close friends that I wrote the song about, they all came and were in it. It was great. It was really nice. I'm serious.
Yeah. Tell me how nice it was one more time.
I'm sorry. Yeah.
No, he looks really great behind the wheel of this convertible car. Love it. So we're excited to have you here. You're going to play it for us. But what can we expect from you this summer? What's going on? What's next?
Yeah, so I'm going on a tour in June, and I'm not sure we're hitting Sacramento. I know we're hitting San Francisco, so come over and hang out. Yeah. In June, July.
So you're just touring all summer?
All summer, yeah. It's going to be great.
Nothing exciting? Birthdays popping up that you have to stop the tour for and make sure you celebrate?
No birthdays right now.
Okay, well, I can tell you mine is August 17th.
August 17th. Okay, yeah.
So that way you won't forget, and we can celebrate.
Okay.